Hall of Fame quarterback Troy Aikman sharing his thoughts about beer companies looking to profit off the 4th of July.
I've got to call it like it is. There are a lot of beer brands out there that are trying to cash in on this holiday by slapping an American flag on their package, regardless of whether or not they are truly American. So this July 4th, drink American, whether it's 8 Beer or any other American-owned beer brand. And on behalf of all of us out here, we appreciate your support. Cheers.
Quite the message. Charlie Arnolds is the host of Outkick, and she joins us now. Charlie, good morning to you. What do you think about that?
I mean, I think it's just another kick to Bud Light while they're down, which I love. I think most people love, because Bud Light totally deserves it. We're just waiting for an apology still. Did you see the commercial that Bud Light put out?
I did.
Just recently, it's like, maybe not the correct direction to go out, try to make everyone just look like complete morons instead of, you know, just giving a simple apology. So what Troy Aikman is saying is absolutely true. I think there's a lot of beer companies out there fronting to be ultra patriotic and, you know, catering to the audience that they are hoping to attain, like Bud Light would be. But it's probably not happening. I don't think many people are going to be reaching for that beer this holiday.
Well, it's also important to note that literally 2/3 of the most popular beers that are drunk in the United States of America are foreign owned. Yeah. So think about that as you're making your beer purchasing. Mm-hmm. I bought Yingling on Saturday.
Interesting choice.
I went with my 2.5-year-old. We bought beer together. It was a beautiful moment.
Teaching them
early. Gotta teach them, yeah. Meantime, trans cyclist Austin Killips claims that transgender athletes are underrepresented. Mm-hmm. Austin Killips said this: the amount of energy that has gone into building this narrative would lead you to believe that there's this massive number of trans athletes participating in sports and winning all the time, when the reality is that we are statistically underrepresented. So to be clear, he's pointing at that biological men are underrepresented in women's sports.
That's so strange, isn't it?
Yeah.
That there wouldn't be tons of men in women's sports, huh? Mm-hmm. What an interesting thought. I mean, this is just the left's rhetoric all the time. They just constantly are spewing hate, when meanwhile, if you say one thing back to them, you're the one who's labeled as hateful or a bigot. And this whole idea that men should be competing in women's sports is absolutely ludicrous. I mean, we just saw Austin Killips. He won a cycling race by more than 5 minutes.
Yeah.
So
right.
If that doesn't tell you something, I'm not sure what does.
Yeah, I think I do understand what Austin Killips is saying, in the sense that from a statistical standpoint, the number of trans people in this country is very small, although it is growing, and it's growing all at once, which is there's got to be a reason as to why that's happening. And the other thing also is, if you are a young girl, a swimmer, a track athlete, and you are put in that position, it's a big deal to you, no matter how many people across the country are trans.
Well, the thing is, like you said, there's not so many trans athletes that have tried to make the move into women's sports, but they are the ones screaming the loudest. So it's still something we're hearing about constantly.
Right.
And you talk about the trauma this inflicts on these girls and women. And not only are they having to let go of their opportunities to make way for these men who are entering into their space, but also forced to share a locker room, and many times, you know, with these men. And it's just not right.
It's also the point, if there are no rules, then any dude who doesn't even identify as transgender could say, I'm a woman, so you could win the prize money, and that's not right.
And that's what's happening.
Speaking of money, the world's sometimes most wealthy man in the world, Elon Musk, his mother, May, says the fight between her son, Elon, and Meta owner Mark Zuckerberg ain't happening.
Uh-oh.
She tweeted, quote, actually, I canceled the fight. Haven't told him yet, but I will continue to say the fight is canceled just in case.
She's beautiful.
How funny. She's gorgeous. But how funny is it that literally the sometime richest man in the world is being shut down by his mom?
This is a good mom for you, though, right? they don't make moms like this anymore, except for you, right, sitting right here.
Aww.
I mean, Mama Musk wants to protect her son.
Yeah.
And she realizes that Mark Zuckerberg, he's trained in jiu-jitsu, right? He's got some skills underneath
his... He does train.
He's still Mark Zuckerberg.
Do you think do you think this fight's going to happen?
I do think it's going to happen. Dana White has said he spoke to both guys. They are totally serious about making it happen. But obviously, it's not about the money. Neither of them need an extra dollar in their bank accounts. This is about bragging rights. And I feel like there should be an extra incentive on the line. Like, maybe you have to be my assistant for the day. Something just funny to add a little bit of flair to
charity, and you have to be my assistant, carry my coffee for the day. I love that idea.
We've got literally 5 seconds. Who you got in this fight?
I'm taking Elon Musk all day.
There we go.
You knew that.
No matter what happens, it will be one to watch if it does, in fact,
please join
happen.
The conversation.
Thank you.
Put your comments and suggestions below in the comments section.
And click
Thank
here
you for
to
subscribing
to the
this news channel.
YouTube page.
You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the McCad TV family. Please like and share McCad TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.